Okay, listen, you know what time it is. We've got a Box Mania special coming up for you, and it's a very special one. We're at the Jimmy Egan's gym in Wythenshawe. Now listen, this gym is a beacon for the community. There's not many people around Wythenshawe that don't know about this gym, and it's produced some amazing professional fighters, okay? Don't forget, professional fighters all start off as amateurs. We're not talking about any old fighters, by the way, okay? We're talking about people like Tyson Fury, like Huey Fury, like Hosea Burton, like Kofi Yates, like Macaulay McGowan, like Jimmy Kelly. I mean, these guys are serious, seasoned professionals now. They all started at this gym. We caught up with the head trainers. We had a chat with all the kids in the gym. And I'm telling you something, it was a great experience. Hope you enjoy this. Check it out.
As Steve and Sean Egan, it's an absolute pleasure for me and a privilege to be sat with you. As I've known you many years, and you know, it's great to be back in the old gym that I used to come to myself. Just I'll start with you, Steve. Just tell us a little bit about the history of the gym, and you know, when your dad's great Jimmy Egan there started it off, and you know, what you know about the story of Egan's gym.
Well, we started 37 years on Saturday, Saturday coming, the 14th of January 1980, when he first opened his own gym at the Forum. And we've been going ever since. Like my dad always said, we should have been called the nomads, didn't he? Because we kept moving that many times. We've had 13 gyms and six different names. Kept going here and there. And keeping the lads active, you know, keep them busy, even if they weren't boxing, you know what I mean, you try and keep them at it, keep them fit, put them on the right track in life, and just, you know, be a good boxer as well. Great.
What do you love about this gym?
Hard work, dedication, pushes you to the absolute limit, brings the best out of you. It works on you as well, so it like works everybody to their own like style, so it won't try changing you. It'll just make what you've got better and bring the best out of you.
Yeah, great. And Liam, what's it like working in a gym with so many like people of your own age? Have you made lots of friends here from this gym?
Yeah, you do make lots of friends. You know, it's like everybody cares for each other, like that, and you know, we all work together.
Yeah, that's good, man. And what got you into boxing?
I don't know, I think it was just like watching it on the TV, and you know, we just started getting into it.
Brilliant.
I'm here now.
I love the fact that you're still nice to each other after a hard spar.
Gosh, yeah.
Now, what is it? Brother, it's dedication, you find family, it sort of brings you closer to everybody, it also shows you discipline, respect. It teaches you, it taught me basically about life, like you show everybody respect no matter what. Obviously, like you said, you get in the ring, you punch each other for, in the amateurs, 3 rounds, 4 rounds, professional 12, but they always shake hands afterwards, you're always giving each other respect. All right, as a pro, you build the fight up beforehand, but that respect's still there after the cameras have gone off. So to me, I would suggest it to anybody and everybody, and the people that think it's a violent sport, it's not. It's just, well, yeah, obviously it's a bit of violence, but it's more respect and discipline, and it helps a lot of people to get through whatever situation you're in, and it toughens you up as well, I suppose, in a way.
Brilliant. Same question to you then, Liam.
I can't top that.
It was a good answer, that, wasn't it?
He always had that dream, didn't he, your dad, to find a champion. He said, you know, this is the biggest council estate in Europe. He had that dream that he'd find champions from here, and, you know, lo and behold, as the years have rolled on, he has as well.
It's out there on the wall, on a page from his diary, the day the gym opened, printed out on the wall over there, saying about that, how many homes and kids are in Wythenshawe and that, and obviously, you know, if he, what was it?
If you can't find, can't find a champion amongst that lot lately,
We've had obviously quite a bit of success, haven't we?
And like he said, you know, like the nomads, there's been that many homes. I've been to a few myself over the years where you've been, but it was always hard for him to get a secure base, wasn't it? And you'd think that the good that this gym has done in the area, and you know, the lives that has changed, it shouldn't be that hard to, you know, to do that, really.
Every gym we got, someone seemed to find a use for it, you know what I mean? So we lost out again, you know, a useless bit of a prefab. Yeah. We'd done it up and made it a use, and people got, you know, probably thought, oh, we could use that, and kind of took it off us all the time, didn't they? You know what I mean? Which is a joke, really. And then, you know, finally, unfortunately, after my dad went, we got this place, you know, which is, we've got a long, long lease on it, so... Yeah, at least we're permanent home for now, but we could do with being bigger, as you see tonight. I mean, that's not as full as it can get. I mean, it can get ridiculous, can't it?
Yeah, three on each bag, sometimes.
And, you know, of all the homes, like you said, you know, you settled here now, and it's been a few years now since the old fella passed away, and, you know...
13 years
now, and... You know, at what point after that did you feel it was the right thing to keep his legacy going, keep the gym going, and
straight
to keep his dreams going?
That's what he wanted, on his, you know, basically on the deathbed, to look after your mum, and the gym goes on.
Yeah.
And it's gone more than on, hasn't it? You know?
I had that chat with him before he went.
25 national champions since he's passed away, so it's gone more than on, hasn't it? You know what I mean? We've done all right.
Mm. When, you know, somebody goes to the shop and they drop dead at the shop, you don't get a chance to speak to him. Obviously, we knew my dad was going. Straight from the diagnosis, they said 2 to 5 years. It lasted 2 years, so it gives you time to talk, you know, and you say things that you wouldn't normally say, like men, you know, the macho side. Anyway, I said to him, what do you want to happen when you go? And he said, look after your mum and keep the gym going. That's it. So we didn't break, we just carried, you know. Did we have a week off?
No, I don't think we did.
You know, from him dying, the gym just stayed open.
And he collapsed one Monday morning, and it could have had a speak cut in, you know, and we wanted to stay with him in the house, and he was in bed in the parlour, and I said, do you want to go to the gym? So we come, left him there with everyone else, and come in on the Monday night and done the gym as normal, like. But obviously, we was empty, weren't we? You know, knowing what's happening.
Well, like you said, Bonnie, you don't realise, you know, you're in like a state of shock for a good while afterwards. You're just working away and you don't realise till you come out of it that, you know, the condition you was in, sort of thing. Mm. And then we started to push on and we started to get decent results and get champions and that, you know. So we've done well since then, haven't we? We've done well, you know. And
I'd say that first year, we didn't notice it, did we, as such, till the start of the next season. But like, the full gym was in the morning and we didn't see it because it's our dad and we think, well, we're getting on and...
Well, you knew him, Chris. Training. You knew him.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You spent enough time around him, didn't you, and that, and knew what he was like.
He was a father figure to me, as he has been to many people, taught me a good few lessons, and he was that, you know, that father figure, that authority figure in my life at an important time when I was a teenager.
Kid, though, it wasn't just in the street, in it, you know, anywhere, you know, just anybody. It was just nice to everyone. You know what I mean?
He wasn't always nice to me when I didn't come training.
Oh yeah, not nice in the gym, but outside the gym, it's nice to everyone.
But you need that drive, you need someone there pushing you, and that's what coaches are there for, isn't it?
Yeah. Jimmy, we're over at Jimmy Egan's gym. You know it well, it's where you started your boxing career, and you know, fond memories of coming through the ranks here. You know, you boxed for him, won many things under him. You know, coming back here and seeing all the kids training and doing what you did, you know, it's good to come here and see that, and to, you know, go back a few years here. You know, it's a special place for you.
It is, like I said, we've stood in a ring, and they've had this ring since before I was, before I was here. This is the first ring we've sparred in. I got my ass kicked the first time I sparred in this ring, so, you know, to come back, it's, it's always a place that's in my heart. You get what I mean? It's on the estate, I live around the corner, so let's have a little short journey over, and, you know, you see all the kids coming through, and it's produced, like, a lot of talent over the years. You know, I've obviously challenged for a world title. Tyson Fury's heavyweight champion. He's brought a lot of people through, like I said, Kofi's fighting Tommy Coyle in a couple of weeks. McCauley's there doing his thing. George Brennan. So he's brought a lot of good talent through him to come back, and it's just the constant conveyor belt. Now we've got fighters who are here. You've got Opie Burton, who's fought as well, his brother Samson's national champion from here. So it's a place that's close to me, and it's just on the doorstep, you know, and it's a place that this day calls for. You got, you know, I haven't got much around here, and just takes kids off the street, and, you know, Steve and Sean have been doing it for years, and, you know, they took over from their dad, who's doing it for even more years, you get what I mean?
just a place that's changed people's lives on the estate, and it's put people on the right path. And you know, I think this place owes, is owed a lot of thanks to a lot of people who it's sent them, you know, down the right path and kept them off the street. So, you know, it's a
I'm sure there's a few Jimmy Kelly's, Tyson Fury's, Kofi Yates coming through there.
You know, it could be better. You get what I mean? There could be someone out there who's, you know, going to outshine us all, and you know, you have to hope that they will do. Yeah, no doubt that, you know, my son's only just been born, but when he's old enough, I'm going to just walk across the road and take him there. He's, you know, the next one on the convey road. So yeah, it's it's just constant. All you get what I mean? It's just a constant talent pool, you know, people go and turn pro. I know that Steve and Sean are going to start doing non-professional now, but you know, you've got to be like, you know, my dad was chatting to me, I go eat for 10, you know, and you've got, you know, in 10, 15 years time, he could be up there, you know, would be a world champion. You never know, it's just constant, you get me, constant talent coming through and time being put into them, and, you know, it's just good to see in hindsight, you know, maybe in 10 years time we're looking back at a video of him in the background, you get what I mean, and he's up there to turn professional, so you just never know, do you?
Okay, listen, we're at Jimmy Egan's gym here, we've got Courtney McCarthy, and I've just seen her training, and damn, you've got some moves! Firstly, what got you into boxing?
Like, when I was in primary school, I was sat down on the floor, you know, I was being primary school kids do.
Yeah.
And Steve and brought two older lads in, Kofi Yates and Macaulay McGowan, and did some pads with them and that. And then it just made me think, that's what I want to try out and do. And then I come here at a young age, you know, tried it out, and then I loved it. And then I watched Rocky films and all, which inspired me as well.
Yeah.
And then obviously that's what got me into it. And then, but mostly Steve was the one that inspired me to do it in that.
So. Brilliant. I mean, we've had a couple of girls on the show.
Yeah.
And it's great to see more girls getting involved with boxing.
Yeah.
When you sort of told like your friends and family and whatever that you wanted to go into boxing, what did they say about that?
Well, my mum, obviously, your mum's a mum, innit? Like, she loves me doing it and that, but she's a bit, do you know what I mean? She don't feel like she's one of them, do you know what I mean? Where my dad, he absolutely loves it and that, like, my mum's supporting, but she's a bit sceptical of my like, girl art, so.
Has she seen you train, though?
Yeah,
has she seen how good your head movement is?
Yeah, she loves it, do you know what I mean? She said it's somebody, but that's the cat.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
Obviously, and like everyone at the gym supports me, Steve, Mark, Sean, all the trainers, and then obviously I love Steve, and he's the main man in here, and like a couple of the other main lads as well, and the main coaches. If you want for them as well, I wouldn't be here where I am now.
Brilliant, and what would you say to like other girls that want to get involved then, that are maybe a bit sort of nervous to get involved?
Just basically, you know, take it on the chin, do you know what I mean? If you like it, then do what you like, do you know what I mean? Like, it's a mint sport at the end of the day, do you know what I mean? And girls out there that are nervous to do it. I was nervous, you know what I mean? Everyone's nervous to do it and get in the ring and that, but I just say to all girls out there, it is a mint sport and they would love it, do you know what I mean?
Jim's been called many names as well, hasn't it, over the years, and you know, it's fitting that he's changed it to the Jimmy
away.
Egan.
Certainly, he would never have called it after himself, would he? It was never about my dad.
I told him before he went. It was Steve's idea, to be fair, you know what I mean? And I remember speaking to him again, you know, and I said to him, you know, the gym's going to be putting your name, you know what I mean? And he looked at me like, and gave me a bit of a wry smile, you know, but it's nice, you know.
He would never have done it himself.
He wouldn't,
And it's not Egan's, it's, you know, when they announce fights, win or lose, whatever, Egan's gym or, it's Jim Egan's, you know what I mean? And first few seasons, we remind them all the time that we book, it's just like, people call it Egan's now, but it's still Jim Egan's, you know what I mean, no matter what.
Then we're here with Lewis Parry, and Lewis, I hear you're doing pretty well at the minute. Tell us a little bit about your record.
Well, I've had 30 amateur bouts, I've won 11.
Yeah.
I won the national title last year in the Northwest twice.
What age did you start boxing?
14, came in at gym 14. Weren't the best when I started, but said there was something about me, so I just kept training hard and putting the work in, and then they've had it all in the gym. Blood, sweat, tears is what they say, isn't
that's
it?
That's it,
and then it's paid off, hasn't it?
Well, it's interesting what you say there, so you've actually developed a lot in this particular gym.
Yeah.
So what is it about the trainers at this gym that have seen you come so far?
It's just a big family feel, isn't it? Just come in the gym and then you're all friends and it's motivating.
Yeah, I've noticed that myself actually. Now, does that spur you on then to do better? Because you know everyone in the gym is like your friend and like someone you sort of care about. Does that actually help you?
Well, when you come in, you're just with your mates, aren't you? So when you're on the back, with your mates, you just like, I usually chant them on and then they chant you on.
Yeah.
And then you just come on champ and then you just work and work and work.
What are you looking at to do then for yourself this year?
Achieve the ABA title.
Yeah,
definitely
nice.
On that. Running nearly every day, eating well.
Would you say that boxing here, down at Egan's gym here, has had a really positive effect on your life?
Yeah, because before I came to the gym, believe it or not, I was quite an annoying kid, to be honest.
Yeah.
Was in my house, putting all through doors, you know what I mean? Yeah. Came here, and my mum was just absolutely happy.
Brilliant.
And that's what makes me happy, just making my family happy.
Yeah. No walls through them doors anymore?
No walls through the doors, getting along with everyone. Yeah. Just, it's changed my life massively.
Brilliant. And just finally, what would you say to anyone, how old are you?
16.
16. What would you say to any 16-year-olds out there who want to get involved in boxing? What would you say to them?
Just come along, just train. Now, I've had a few people like just drop me a message before, but like, well, Jimmy Egan's Boxing Academy just come along train.
Quality. Well, listen, wish you all the best, man. We'll be keeping an eye out for you. Right. This is Lewis Parry. Remember that name. You heard it here first.
And the legacy has carried on. You've mentioned there some national champions, school board champions, the whole lot on the amateur scene, and a lot of them have gone on to become not only good professionals, but you could say great professionals. Starting with Tyson Fury. Just tell us, some of the boxers who have come through here, and some of the people have come through here, and gone on to do well in the sport and in life in general. Really,
we've got Jimmy Kelly, haven't we? Jimmy Kelly, world title challenger, Tyson. World champion at one time, and soon to be again, I reckon. McCallum McGowan is doing really well, professional. Kofi Yates is doing fantastic. Taza Purgis is doing well. Wolfie Byrne was British champion, and soon he'll get it back again.
Huey Fiore.
Yeah, Huey Fiore was there. You know what I mean? Yeah. Tyson's cousin.
All come through as kids. And, yeah. You know,
his first fight here, yeah. Yeah, he's doing well now as an Arsenal.
Yeah, he is.
And you know, you're proud of what you do for them as boxers, but as people as well. Some of the kids we spoke to today, the way they come across and what it does for them as people, that's as important to you as teaching them how to throw a good jab and a hook.
Yeah. Going to schools, Chris. Been called in. Would you come in and speak to one of the kids that comes to the gym? Had a few issues with him. Go in, have a sit down, say to him, if you don't behave at school, you're gonna have to leave the gym. Things like that. It's the way my dad would have done it, and that's what we try to do.
Mm. Yeah, they get a bad report, you don't come to the gym, your mum and dad, we tell them off, do it again, you're not coming, Punish them, don't let them come, they love to come here, they're not good at home, they can't come here, And that's up to the parents to say, no. We find out about it, we tell them, don't we? Tell them straight.
No cheek.
We've got Conor Taylor here, one of the amateur fighters. He's making me look short as hell, right? So I'm going to stand on my tiptoes. Firstly, Conor, what's it like? You're training at this gym, man. Busy and thriving today, isn't it?
It's a spit and sawdust gym, so the craft goes on here. This is where it all started. It's where, the likes of Kofi Yates, McCallum McGowan, Jimmy Kelly Jr. is in the gym today. All them big boys, even Tyson Fury, this is where they started. And from a spit and sawdust gym, so the hard work, and that's it.
Why did you get into boxing yourself?
My big brother, come to his gym, so not as a boxer himself, just to keep fit, and then that was it really. I was starting from there. I put myself when I was a kid with Mark Greenley on a kid session, and then it just escalated from there really.
Right, Glenn, how old are you?
I'm 17.
17, right. What sort of advice would you give to other 17-year-olds who want to get involved in boxing?
Boxing, it changes your life, but it gives you the discipline. If you're getting in trouble, it takes you away from that. You're in a gym, you make new friends. Nothing negative comes from it, it's all positive, so you learn how to defend yourself. It's a great thing to get into.
Brilliant. And are you looking to have some active fights yourself or not?
Yeah, I've got the ABAs at the end of this month, start of February, so looking to win them. And looking forward to a busy season.
Quality. Now listen, this is Conor Taylor. Is it your first interview on British boxers?
Yeah.
Won't be the last, alright?
Won't be the last, yeah.
Remember this face, it's a good looking face this one, isn't it? Am I even in the shot? I'm so bloody tiny.
But who have you got coming through now, with other future Tyson Furies and Jimmy Kellys and the like?
You don't have to throw names because everyone's a potential champion, aren't they? You know what I mean? Yeah. Every single kid. I mean, one of the best kids we've ever had, Dave Burrows. I mean, very ordinary as a kid. Very ordinary. You know Dave. Yeah. Awesome. Dave should have been world champion, but he quit at 19, all done. But yeah. Potential, you can't just look at a kid and say, oh, he's no good.
Yeah. People want to wrote work him off, didn't they? People wrote him off when he was young.
Yeah.
He'll never make a boxer. There was more to it than that, but basically, he'll never make a boxer. He won schoolboys, won it? National title, junior ABAs,
yeah.
Boys clubs, CYPs, yeah. Mm-hmm. Senior ABA title, box for England, should have gone to the Olympics. Mm. You know.
And everything your dad and yourselves have achieved for the gym, you know, what's the future and how do you see, and where do you want to take it? And
well, like I say, we named a few people that have been here, haven't we? You know what I mean? And gone on and do well professional. And we both think it's about time that, you know what, no one's leaving here. If you're boxing for us, you're going pro with us. Mm. So that's what we're going to do next.
The team's expanded as well. We've got a lot more people involved with the gym now. You know, we've got more coaches.
A lot of good coaches, yeah.
There's about 13, 14 volunteers altogether now in the gym. Mm. And I think, you know, providing everybody can get along and, you know, it's like any organisation, you expand and that. You know, you've all got to get on and that. I think, you know, if we can all gel together properly. We've been okay up to now. Everything's been fine. Mm. It's given us other strings to our bows, so that's allowing us to push on with the pro side and that, you know.
I've been in about half a year. It's a good gym. Train your hard so you can fight easier. I've had two skills, I've had one fight. Good. I recommend it to anyone if you want to do it. It's anyone's sport. To keep them fit. It's a good sport to keep you active and keep you fit. I was doing other sports and then I got bored of them where I was just sat in my house doing nothing. And I wanted to do like sport or get active. So my mate recommended me boxing and well, started coming.
I like the coaches because they're nice and friendly and you can like get active to the gym instead of like going bored and not like doing anything. And then about the gym, like you can keep active, stay fit and then not sitting on your bum all day in your house just playing on games. I like boxing because it's helped me keep my stamina going and I like because I like to get my anger out a lot. I recommend boxing more because like it's more of a fun activity than like other sports like
And what would you say parents maybe who think that boxing's a bit rough, maybe they don't want their kids to get into it, what would you suggest to them why they should?
Because then they can become professional and then they can become famous and get people to know them a lot more and I don't think it's right.
And if there was a kid who wanted to do boxing but his parents didn't think he should, or you know, what would you say, what would you be your answer to them?
I'd say it'd be allowed because if he wants to do that kind of sport to help him out in like life, because he might be getting bullied or out, he could attack, like they could be attacking him and then he could step up to them and then do anything he wants to them, and you'd be able to like stay fit and active. That they'll be able to meet like friends, and just in case they don't have any friends, then they might be able to meet friends here at the Jimmy Egan
Boxing Academy. So, yeah. Brilliant. I'd recommend you to come to the job. So, it's been a struggle for you to eventually find a secure base, but you know, to funding as well. And you know, we're not trying to do a charity thing here, but it, you know, the reality of it is hard, isn't it? And yeah, look at three to a bag tonight, and you know, a bigger place wouldn't.
We are a proper shoestring gym, aren't we?
Yeah.
You know what I mean, but
some of the backs are repaired with seatbelt material and things like that.
It's a continuous struggle, isn't it? You know, what yous are doing is just remarkable for the community, for the area, for the kids that come through here, changing lives, as we've spoke about. You know, you'd think maybe the local council or even some local businesses or, you know, would get involved and help.
Well, you think the size of Wythenshawe, you know what I mean? And the firms that are around here, you've got Charleston Industrial Estate, Bagley Industrial Estate, the airport, you know what I mean? The firms that must be massive multi-million pound firms. No. You know, we've been here 37 years, we're not going away. It's not like we're going to have the money and get off. We're here forever like my dad was, you know what I mean?
Mm. Yeah.
So if you want to be part of the story, part of the journey, taking it to the next level, we're here, let's say, give us a help for them.
I'm one of the coaches, more so a judge, referee and supervisor. So I'm the club officials basically. I do a lot on the officiating side as well as coaching.
How did you get involved in a club in a first
place? Well, Steve Egan's a really, really good mate of mine. I've known Steve forever. And a few years ago, I had a couple of heart attacks. And yes, there's, you know, sort your lifestyle out, you know, and get involved, you know, help out with the kids and become a judge. That's how it started. From judge, it went to supervisor, then to ref, then to coach. And I've been at it ever since. Absolutely love it. Time in my life, it's great.
And you know, I mean, it's packed out, isn't it? Most nights, and there's loads of kids here. It's a real great resource for the area, and you know, it's give you a lot in your life. It's doing that for a lot of the other people here as well, the coaches and the kids as well.
The kids are great. They're from all walks of life, and you know, they're all local Wythenshawe kids. It's absolutely, I mean, we do attract them in from outside the area, but it's having the local kids, you know, getting them involved, keeping them off the streets, and you just get a lot out of it. I mean, it sorts our life out, it sorts my life out, gives me a good purpose in life, and I feel great that I'm passing on what I know out of them, you know what I mean? And it just, it'll make you continue. It's the best thing in Wythenshawe, without shadow of a doubt, it really is. Well, I mean, it's a discipline side for one thing. Kids that have got no discipline, they get so much out of it, you know. Giving them that little bit of discipline gives them self-respect. A lot of them haven't got any self-respect, they haven't got confidence. They come to a gym like this, and parents that have had trouble with kids, all of a sudden they're learning the respect element of it as well. It works both ways. You know, the parents start to respect the kids start to respect the parents. And we've now got parents in the gym that have got the kids here now. Which, again, it's fantastic because you find them really, really bonding. And to see a father and son relationship develop in the gym. I see it now. We've got one of the coaches, Steve, and look at the relationship with his son. You know, and you think, wow, that's fantastic. And we should have had that with my son. Well, I did, but that was in a martial arts background. But in the boxing side, I see them come together and I think, absolutely brilliant, it really is. And again, it is one of them where you don't see it in the sports, you know, the bonding that's there. In the boxing world, it's just totally different from any other sport. You know, really, people think it's a violent sport. Yeah, not a violent sport, it's a sport. I mean, you see a father and a son, yeah, work together as a team. You can't get any stronger than that. It's an unbreakable bond. And I think all the coaches as well, we've got that bond with all the kids here. You know, and if you just walk around the gym now, well, earlier, and you see how many kids are in, and the older lads, yeah, there's a real sense of family values in here. You know, and we are one big family. We're just a massive Jimmy Egan family. And you don't see that, and it's just great to see it. I'm just hoping it ends.
Okay, we've got Rob and Jack Edge here, father and son duo at Egan's gym. Firstly, tell us about the gym. Why you guys love training here, and why you know what it's all about?
We started coming down when Jack wanted to get into boxing, and one of the coaches here called him. I sent him a text and said, you know, Jack wants to get involved. Where should we come anyway? He pointed us this way. We came down, and we've not stopped since. Yeah. That was about 14 months ago now. And three times a week, we've not stopped. So I started myself about 6 months ago, seeing how well he was doing. I thought, well, I'm here anyway while he's training, so I thought, give it a bash.
So what is it about this particular gym that makes it like, you know, for you as a father to trust your son to be here?
I don't know really. I mean, when he first started coming down on a Tuesday, which was for the kids, which Mark does. And it's just a really good atmosphere. Mark was brilliant with him, so you know, I left him here a few times, and it was banged on and stuff. So you know, obviously, like I said, I know Colin down there, so it's just a great place to be. It really is.
Yeah, bro. And how old are you?
14.
14. Right, great. And have you made some friends and stuff here at the gym?
Yeah, a lot.
Yeah. What do you like most about the gym?
Training and keeping fit.
Yeah. What made you first think to yourself that you wanted to get involved in boxing? It's a pretty tough sport to get involved in, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, I had some trouble like on the streets and that.
Yeah.
Like getting to like fights all the time, and I wasn't very good. Mm. So I started boxing and it proper settled it.
Give you discipline and everything.
Yeah.
Like. Yeah. Yeah. Nice. And have you had any fights yet?
Yeah. Four.
And have you got them?
Really well, actually.
Yeah?
Lost my last one.
Okay, bro. And do you want to just sort of elaborate a little bit on this sort of... It's almost like it's got a family feel as well a little bit, this gym.
It has, you know. It really has. I mean, to be honest with you, I was a bit wary at first, you know, coming down here, you know. You think there might be a few idiots knocking about and stuff. And to be honest with you, I've not met one.
Mm.
And you can see how busy the gym is now, and there's not one bad personality in here, there really isn't.
Yeah.
Everyone gets on with each other dead well, the trainers are brilliant, so can't knock it at all.
Yeah.
Really can't, you know, it'd break my heart if you have to go somewhere else, you know.
Yeah.
And just elaborating on what Jack used to be like, you know, before we came down, he was getting into a bit of miser. A couple of kids who lived around us are getting into scraps and stuff like that, and his personality as well has come out a lot better. You know, it's not just all about the boxing and things like that. It's how he's handled himself, the way that, you know, the way that he talks and everything, you know, his schoolwork's improving, it's mental, it really has brought him on, so, you know.
That's brilliant. So what would you say then to the people who would often say, oh, boxing, that's just for like, you know, that's just for ruffians, that's not...
Well, it's not, it really isn't, you know, it's what I would say is, I mean, I'm 35 now, and I've always been into exercise and stuff like that, and it's very, very difficult. It's very technical, and it's very difficult, and it, you know, and it's just really, really good to learn, especially for these kids, the way that they're doing it. There's some great talent in it, and it's just great. It just really is. I can't put a finger on it, but it is. It just works, you know.
So. And you must be a cool dad, you know, because you come down to the gym with your dad, and you know, you let him train with you. So it must be all right then, eh?
Yeah, it's brilliant.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, listen, guys, it's been brilliant just having a little chat with you there.
Oh, nice one,
fantastic.
Yeah.
What would you say to any other parents in the area or kids who, you know, want to come down and get involved? How can they get involved, and why would you suggest that they should get involved in boxing?
Discipline, manners, and respect is the first thing. Fitness,
health, yeah.
Confidence, well-being, self-defense. I mean, you can be a star. You want to come here and work hard, you can be a star. If you want to work hard and listen and do what we say, you'll get to the top. You know what I mean?
And it's proven.
It's proven. Yeah. I mean, come here, do the hard work, do as you're told, dedicate your life to it like we dedicate to the coaching. You know what I mean? Not just me and him, I mean all the coaches. I mean, we all play our part. We're a great team. We are a team. Jimmy Egan's here, the team. And there ain't many gyms that are like ours. We are a team.
People say it's like a family, don't they? You know,
we
look at
kids.
Some of the reviews on Facebook and things like that, you know. Well, that's what they say, you know, like some of the...
There's no ego in there. No one's king of the gym. We don't do that. You know what I mean?
Don't have your favourites. They're all the same, aren't
yeah.
they?
Mm-hmm. Certain lads get a bit more work because they're in something, championships, blah, blah, blah. If you keep winning, keep getting in thingy, finals, semi-finals, stuff like that, you're going to get more pad work because you're on it all the time. So, you know, it's not favouritism, just part of ease in the zone and... He needs a bit more work, you know what I mean, to keep him up there. You know, there's no favourites, no matter how great you are.
Start sessions we do, don't we? We do these start sessions, we have two sessions a week, Tuesday, Thursday, you know, for the kids. Mm. They come in. We've got a women's night as well now, dedicated just for women only.
Yeah, it's a Thursday night, you know. 7 till 9. They're moaning it's going to go on night, but like I said, I've worked with him upstairs, give him a couple more days a week. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. He's not enough hours in
that's
the day.
That's it, yeah. We all work.
Sunday morning nursery session.
Yeah, yeah.
It's 5-year-old thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, like just doing little bits. Only in for an hour, a bit of messing about and that, but they're picking up. You know, apparently doing bits and bobs. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And it, you know, yourselves and coaches up and down the country. You know, the hard work and dedication that you've put in. You know, sometimes goes untold. Yeah. You know, and,
I think boxing coaches, most of, say 90% of the most dedicated coaches you can get. Well, because it needs so much of the kid. You know what I mean? The coach has got to be the same. You've got to be more dedicated than them. Your enthusiasm rubs off on them.
Yeah.
If you come in like, can't be asked tonight, you know what? They're not going to be asked. No matter what a bad day you've had, however you're feeling, you've got to come here and give them a lift and get into their head. And
that's
get
most
into
gyms, aren't they?
You inspire them to be great, to be better, to be special, to be what they can be, the best they can be.
And that's it. You've got to always be ahead in the dedication and the discipline yourselves. And you know, you can't. You've got to practice what you preach. And
some nights you think, you know what, I've had a bad day at work, but you know, you might drive anything. You know, you open the door, nice guy, and it just gives you a lift. You know, the kids are nice, and you think, right, you know, could have had a horrible day. By the time you go out and do anything, yeah. You know what I mean? It's great for us as well, isn't it?
They come like that as well sometimes, you know, tired from school or college or whatever, you know, wherever they've been. Don't want to train. They train and they go home like with more energy because they have trained, you know what I mean? So, it's like a knock-on effect, isn't it, really, with everyone in the gym.
Like being dolphins, isn't it? any type of training, happy endorphins, and that's what it gives.
It's great to see you carrying on Jimmy's legacy.
Yeah,
he was a remarkable
boss.
Guy.
He's still a boss.
It was remarkable what he did. It's absolutely remarkable what you're doing. Utmost respect for you, as I did your dad, and long may it continue. God bless you guys.
And it's great you coming here, Chris, because you're part of the story as well, mate. You know what I mean? So,
well, this
thanks for coming.
Always a lot in my heart, this place, yeah. Always will be.
Brilliant.
Thanks, guys.